sweeter than your honey did. Sweet country man, think you're sweet. Sweet country man, I think you're country boys. Now honey did. Sweet country man, sweet country man, I think your country band is sweeter than your honey tits. Oh, sweet country man, I think your country band is sweeter than your honey tits.
Decided to go and sign with the Houston Rockets, and Kobe Bryant's a guy that the shelf life on him isn't going to be too much longer. So everybody now looks at all the free agents that are out there.
Sure, you can opt out after this year.
Yeah, and could go to the Lakers, because how long do they usually go without a real superstar player? I know you talk about this all the time.
I know. Don't stop me out of Lakers.
The NBA manufactures some of these guys going out there, but Carmelo Anthony, I guess he says, I doubt it, is the quote when he says
I would really be. Not just because he's on my team, but I would be really, really ticked off at this guy if he bolted for the Lakers.
Oh, of course.
Give me a break. I mean, you orchestrated this trade to Denver to come to the Knicks. I mean, you better stay here the rest of your career.
Yeah, and I don't know how this stuff gets started. I know that it was one report from a reputable guy or someone who's tied in the NBA. We don't even need to say his name, but I know how that all starts. But for me, when you're talking about a dream scenario, and that's how he talked about New York guy, everything
right,
for better or worse, I don't care if you're not completely happy here. You've got to at least try to finish the job here. You can't just go out to L.A. and become the face of that franchise. He would just be, people would hate
him. Oh, God. Beyond. Especially going there. Beyond.
Yeah.
I could never stand him again.
It's amazing, though, how sports media works now, because I guess TMZ was one of the first to report this, because they got guys, he's going into restaurants, wherever else, and, hey, what do you think about this?
I keep saying this, because who knows what the deal was. I mean, I don't know how much you were following this last year in Pittsburgh, but who knows, the whole Kevin Garnett thing, and the Honey Nut Cheerios, and I guess him and his wife, I don't know if they had issues, I don't know what it was, I don't know if they were living together or not. I think she is out in L.A. Isn't she, Lala?
Yeah, I believe so. I think they split time. I mean, when you have a gazillion dollars, right, you don't spend
in
one place.
I guess that's true. I guess, they probably got a home in Malibu as well as whatever they got there here in the village or whatever.
Yeah, she had her own reality show with her friends.
How'd that work?
I don't know. My girlfriend watches way too much reality.
You told me that she watches Wilderness, right?
Everything.
The Housewives of Orange County, New Jersey, of New York, of Atlanta. All of that, right?
Yes, absolutely.
The Kardashians.
All the spinoffs of the Kardashians, Kourtney and Kim Take Miami, whatever this La La show was, Breaking Amish. She has got into that as well.
Amish.
There's some boy band, Married to Jonas. She watches that.
Oh, yeah.
Every reality
show. I actually stumbled across this one, which I couldn't believe. This girl, who I guess she was part of the Atlanta Housewives, who's now married to this Atlanta Falcon.
Troy Bierman.
Beerman, right.
Oh, that's Don't Be Tardy to the Party or something.
Yeah,
she watched watches that one,
what
too.
What was this guy thinking about?
I don't know. She's got,
and
like,
she's got like three kids, too.
Three? And then she's got like 10.
I mean, it's
and
unbelievable.
She's pregnant again.
And she's about 5 or 6 or 7 years older than him, too.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, hell, what's the over-under on that marriage?
I mean,
come on.
Well, I mean, it's probably not good. And I think there, she's pregnant again. She's got like 35.
She's pregnant again?
Yes.
Well, how many kids does she have from Veerman?
At least one, right? I don't know. I'm not sure. This might be the first one. I don't know. I have no idea.
I actually stumbled across this one day while I was, you know, flicking through the channels with the changer. And the only reason I stopped and looked at it is because she started talking about her husband who plays for the Falcons. And I'm like, who is this guy?
Yeah, I know. He must be getting his chops busted in a big
way. Oh, my God.
There was one episode where they body painted her with his jersey. So she was basically naked, but they body painted his Falcons jersey.
God.
And then he came home and he was like, yeah.
That's so nice. She was sitting there with, she's like painted in Falcon colors naked.
Yeah.
And he walks in the door.
Right, basically.
Oh,
yeah.
My God.
I don't think he was too happy about it either, because he took a bunch of pictures and then made like a calendar out of it or something. I don't know. Why? How do we get on this?
I don't know. Because you start talking about your girlfriend and all these dumb reality shows.
That's what happens every single time, every night. I'm downstairs, she's upstairs, and I'm watching the Pirates, I'm watching the Penguins,
whatever it is.
And then when the game's over, I go upstairs and there's this smut on, this disgusting television that makes me sick. And it's on and she's watching it. E! News, she watches every night what's going on with the celebrity. It's terrible. It really, I think it makes everybody dumber. I think I really truly believe that these shows make the generation, the people who watch it, just dumber. It's not entertaining anyway. What do I care about?
It is unbelievable.
You know what I do care about? These are the two callers that are on the line right now.
Well, let's get them up.
Because they're my two favorite, two of my favorite.
Oh, it is two of the all-time greats, isn't it? Yeah. For different reasons. Different levels of greatness here, but two of the all-time greats.
Who should I go to first?
Well, I think you should go to Buddy Butchie.
Okay,
right. Let's go to Butchie. I'm not gonna say it. And our toll-free line every hour is brought to you by Mohegan Sun.
Oh, you found it?
Yeah,
now?
Definitely. Brought to you by Mohegan Sun, that I need it now. Visit Margaritaville Resorts Atlantic City, now open. The incomparable Butchie in Bayside is on the fan. Hi, Butchie.